Address earnings, Gujarat Pipavav Port, and we've got Kel Peterson, the MD, joining us on the show right now. Kel, hi, morning. Good to have you on the show. While your bulk volumes and liquid cargo did well in the quarter gone by, your container volumes have declined from the last quarter. What exactly would you say was the reason behind this slow growth?
No, that is correct. We had a downfall quarter on quarter on the container volume, but however, the previous quarter was an all-time high for us. But if we look at for Gujarat Pipavav Port, if we look at the container volume year on year, then we had a growth of 29%, which is something we are very happy with. We have had challenges in the previous years. But this year we have made a turnaround and we have had an all-time record in the port. Quarter on quarter, the LPG for us grew significantly by 58%, but it should also be said it comes from a low previous quarter. We still estimate overall Pan-India that the LPG volumes have grown around 10% year on year. For fertilizer, we have seen an all-time record year for us, and even on quarter on quarter we have seen very significant volumes. So we're quite happy with the results. Financially, we have a higher expense because of the fertilizer, which is very manpower intensive. But at the end, we end up with a better quarter than previous year.
Okay. So how is it that you're reading into the underlying trade indicators at the current juncture? Because first half is traditionally softer than the second. But will it be softer than usual?
I think normally we see that the period during the monsoon is a soft period for the trade. So that is correct. That is what we expect, and then we would normally end up in Q3 with seeing very solid volumes in India.
Okay, EBITDA margins undershooting your aspiration of 60%. Are you hopeful of gaining ground in the coming months?
No, we have previously stated as a company we have an ambitious target of landing around the 60%. So we have some way to go when we look on the quarter and quarter and year and year. But we have had additional dredging cost this year, and we know that when the bulk part of the business is going up, then the margins go slightly down. But it's still contributing to the overall net result. So we are landing at a net profit of 205 crores versus 198. Here in this one, there's incorporated an additional depreciation charge. So if you look at it apple to apple, then we are at 6% on the net profit. So I think decent result, but we would like to grow more.
Okay, the Gujarat Maritime Board has also encashed a bank guarantee and demanded additional GST on the same as you didn't expand bulk capacity as was earlier planned. What should we make of this? Any revision in investment plans?
I don't think you should make too much out of it. We are still in discussion with DMB. Eight years back, there was the high expectation for coal in the port. We have seen coal fading away for our part, but on the other hand, then we have seen the liquid starting up very well since 2014 in the bigger picture, and so has the Ro-Ro export of cars. So it's a dynamic market, things changes, and I believe we have found sufficient replacement business to show a very solid development of the port over the years.
Right, now it's becoming a little difficult to share the volume growth aim for FY20 given the tough trade environment. So is there any estimate that you're working toward?
So we still have healthy targets set up for the company. We have that every year, but we also know that the market changes and there are fluctuations. So we, without mentioning numbers, then clearly we have an increase in our businesses. I think the only one where we are always a little bit hesitant, that is on the development of our bulk, where in particular coal, if you look at it over the last 5 years, is really down. Fertilizer last year we thought it would be down. Pan India it was down 25%, but now we have achieved a record year in DPPL, and we hope that will continue at that level for the coming year. Container business will grow for sure in the overall India, and we are there. We have the capacity to capture part of the market and our share. The same outlook for LPG. I truly believe that the LPG market is a great market. And it has a great future in India. For the Ro-Ro, there are fluctuations. It's not only depending on India, it's also depending on consumers globally and how much appetite they have to buy new cars and so on. So I believe that, over the long term, this is something that will have a very healthy and significant development in the numbers over the coming years.
And finally, save for a soft Q4, but a reasonably good year. How much better can we see your profit growth in FY20 compared to your revenue growth?
So I do think we will grow. We will grow when you look at year on year. I do think we'll grow in LPG or liquid overall, as we say. I do believe we will grow in our container part of the business. And Ro-Ro, we do not expect a significant growth in the next 12 to 18 months, but we do believe it will turn around. And for bulk, as I said, it's hard to predict. But one thing we are proud of also in the company is that we have a very strong support from our customers, and we are in a very healthy manner paying out everything we can in dividend, while we are fairly strong on our cash in the company and we have no debt. So we are ready to sustain and we are ready to fight and continue to grow the company while we look for healthy investments.
Have you on the show, and thanks much for highlighting your fourth quarter numbers and of course the visibility going forward.